Alright, check this out. This little box is ESP32-P4-EYE and it's kind of a tiny Swiss Army camera dev kit. It's so cute, isn't it? There's a camera up front, a little LCD, a mic, a microSD slot, even your USB-C. Wi-Fi and Bluetooth are baked in, so yeah, portable projects are totally a thing here. So the idea is simple. It's a palm-sized vision board that already has most of the stuff you'd normally wire up with a mess of cables. I love that. There's a tiny screen for live preview, which is super handy. So you don't need to tether to a phone or laptop, just see what the camera sees. Basically, it's the weekend prototype board that doesn't make your desk look like a spaghetti factory. Actually, that's mine. You can control menus with this little rotary knob, very clicky. Feels good. This is a LVGL UI. I really like it. The source code for this example is also available, making it very useful for those building their own cameras. FYI, this UI was developed in SquareLine Studio. Unfortunately, the project files are not shared. Now let me take a picture. With 3x zoom, it looks very blurry. Oh, I forgot this. This is manual focus, so you have to turn the lens for focusing. Okay, here you are. Wow, it looks much better than before. This is the result you will get when taking photos with this camera. The resolution of these photos are 1920x1080 and saved to the SD card as JPEG. As you can see, it has a 4x zoom, but since it's not optical, the resolution is very low, so it's not very useful. But without zooming, you can see that the quality is not bad. No Photoshop was used. This is a simple recording video test. It's also at the maximum resolution of 1920x1080. It's saved in MP4 format with audio. One thing, it provides an AI mode. Actually, it's not that special since the ESP32-P4 already provides human face recognition and pedestrian detection as samples. Yeah, I think it has all the simple features we normally have in a digital camera. You can also check images saved on the SD card by directly connecting the USB from your PC. The last one is a simple settings screen. This product does not include a battery, so to make the camera battery powered, you need to buy your repo battery separately and install it into the device. It's annoying. As you can see, there's not much space in the enclosure already, so you will have to buy a very thin battery. FYI, the battery I use here is 3.5mm thin and 25mm by 40mm. It wasn't easy to fit the battery in a small space. After several tries, I think I finally found the right position. One tip is that if you place it too close to the corner, the rotary knob will get stuck and won't turn properly. So leave some space around the knob when installing the battery. That's it. It works good. The best thing for us developers, you get to design the camera UI your way. Hardware's done, now it's just you, some pixels, and your imagination. Add OpenCV, the funk filters, tracking, whatever. That's today's video. See you next time.